This was no fault of the doctor. This is all my fault. I should have been more careful. I should have looked more carefully. Instead, I ruined about a year and a half of my life.
What's up, guys? Derek, morepolicemoredates.com. Today we're going to be talking about one of the OG famous YouTubers in the fitness scene as well as mainstream, Furious Pete. This guy was most well known for his absurd eating challenges as well as this. He had this viral transformation showing before and after fitness transformation in just 5 hours, where he basically had his physique go from zero to hero in a matter of 2 seconds, and basically was one of the first exposing the fitness industry type videos where it showed what really goes into some of these like ridiculous before and afters that you saw in the supplement ads and the magazines and whatnot. Even like Lee Priest and those individuals that would have like the most hyper extreme transformations. Those were examples of guys that just like went off the deep end eating like shit, and they would take like the after picture like before, or they would take the after picture when they're actually preparing for a show again, but it would not necessarily be representative of what was reflective of using the supplement being advertised. Rather, it was getting as fat as fuck on purpose, force feeding yourself like Lee liked to do in the off season, and then cutting up for a show. Not necessarily a fat guy who was out of shape taking the supplement and getting shredded. So Furious Pete did this transformation where he basically got into shape, showed like got into peak condition, and took all the photos, and he would take the after shot before to show what really goes into this stuff. So he would get into like as jacked, you know, get like a pump, he would like douse himself in fucking baby oil or whatever, get the best lighting and get a, you know, like after shot before, and then he would go literally binge eat like a motherfucker and just like have like a disaster cheat day, get bloated as hell, and then he would take the before shot in as unflattering of lighting as possible, sticking his gut out, and he would take the before shot and then make it look like it was a before and after, when in reality he did it all in the exact same day. And this was like the first, you know, like crazy insight into exposing the fitness industry, and at the time this was like revolutionary shit, and it's why it blew up to 25.6 million views. So this guy was a very, very popular YouTuber, and has done a shit ton of eating challenges. Biggest, best, and most famous eats in America, Furious Pete World Tour, Top 10 Burger Challenges, 150 Warheads Challenge, Burrito Eat-Off, 200 Wing Q&A, World's Hottest Pizza. Like, he's done some crazy shit. Michael Phelps Diet Challenge, 12,000 plus calories, Giant Brain Freeze Ice Cream Cone. So, more recently, unfortunately, he has succumbed to cancer, and he had to get both of his testicles removed, unfortunately. So as a consequence of that, he had to go on testosterone replacement therapy because he could no longer produce intratesticular testosterone. He was basically functioning off of adrenal steroid production at that point, which you're basically like, you're castrated essentially. So more recently, he put out a video the other day basically updating people about where he's been, because he hasn't posted very much recently at all. Like, he had 3 weeks ago, 1 month ago, 4 months ago, 5 months ago, 6 months ago, 7 months ago. So like, you know, a couple videos a month at best, and just kind of like falling off the bandwagon a little bit, not the bandwagon, falling off the, I don't know, like falling off track, not being able to post content very frequently, and just not, you know, being like himself. You know, he's a hardworking guy. He used to be grinding on YouTube, and now he just, you know, hasn't had it in him to get much out there. His last TikTok was posted July 24th. And then he posted this recently explaining why. And it's actually pretty fucking insightful and maybe a relevant thing to take into account that may overlap with something very, very notable in your own life with testosterone replacement therapy and why he's felt like shit this whole time for the past year, essentially, or year and a half.
Over the past year, I've been getting asked, what happened to Furious Pete? What happened to all your muscle? What happened to all your videos? For those not familiar, testosterone is the most important hormone in a male. It doesn't just affect your muscle and strength. It affects everything in your body, from hair to skin, to the way your brain thinks, whether you are fatigued, can concentrate, whether you are happy or depressed. So in 2019, after my last battle with testicular cancer, I was left with no nuts, meaning zero testosterone production. I had to go on testosterone replacement therapy, steroids for the rest of my life in order to function. Initially, I was put on one testosterone. About a year and a half ago, that testosterone went on back order, so I was switched to another testosterone. Up until a few weeks ago, I couldn't figure out why I was losing all my muscle, why I had no confidence whatsoever, i.e. no videos, why I couldn't go to the gym. Turns out I needed double of this new testosterone in order to be at the same level as I was with the other one. This was no fault of the doctor. This is all my fault. I should have been more careful. I should have looked more carefully. Instead, I ruined about a year and a half of my life.
So pretty fucking scary, dude. Just a blunt ending like that. You know, he should have been taking double the amount and he wasn't. And just like that, he ruined the last year and a half of his life. So if you're functioning off of, like, you have no testosterone being produced intratesticularly and you rely on TRT, and all of a sudden your dosage administration changes significantly, or you get on a different brand and the milligram per milliliter concentration is different, or even the potency of it varies, you can fuck up your life pretty significantly without even realizing it. Now, for him, he has not made it very clear when he says it's his fault. Like, he makes it sound like the milligram per milliliter on the label or something was different. He just wasn't reading it correctly or wasn't following the correct instructions, and it wasn't the fault of the doctor or something. But, like, you should be getting regular follow-ups. This is why we advise patients to follow up at least, like, on a biannual basis or something. Like, you should be, if you have any kind of aberration in your mental state or in your quality of life in some significant capacity, and you otherwise rely on exogenous hormones to facilitate all kinds of androgenic activity in your body as well as anabolic activity, you notice you're losing muscle, your quality of life is diminishing, your dick's not working the same anymore, your mental drive is like crashing, your sleep is going to shit, your mood regulation is off, like, make a follow-up appointment, you know? Like, it doesn't cost very much to get blood work done, fortunately, especially when you are using a lab builder like at Merrick Health, link in the description below, unashamed plug. You can order literally a sensitive assay, total testosterone, and free testosterone. You can using equilibrium dialysis or equilibrium ultrafiltration for high sensitivity. You don't need to get a giant mega panel to get those two things. You can just add it to your cart separately and check out with that and check what the hell's going on under the hood. Some individuals, it doesn't just boil down to, like, with him, it sounds like he just wasn't, like, dosing it properly for some reason. But some individuals, and this is, like, it even happens at the pharmaceutical level, you'd be shocked, it can vary in potency, like, fairly significantly. Now, again, good compounding pharmacies will not have this issue, but there are some shady fucking compounding pharmacies out there that some, like, unethical companies that have, you know, unethical HRT clinics will work with, because they're very, very loosey-goosey about what they will prescribe. You know, they'll prescribe things like fucking, like, anabolic steroids, like, willy-nilly, you know? Like, stuff that really should not be prescribed to patients. Like, oh, you're on HRT, let's put you on fucking Diebel. Let's put you on Winstrol, because clearly you need that. Like, when is that warranted? When is that justified for a guy who just needs TRT? Like, ultimately, some of these clinics are just run-of-the-mill, fly-by-night, fucking, like, steroid mills, essentially. That was probably a poor way to describe it, but they just operate to pump out scripts of as much as they can and make a shit ton of money, and they defer their patients to compounding pharmacies that are essentially just functioning to prescribe as much, like, unethical shit as possible. Now, again, this is why you have to work with a company that is on the up and up and works with compounding pharmacies that are on the up and up, so you don't end up in a position like this. Because I remember, even back in the day, if you remember Matt Porter, unfortunately a bodybuilder that passed away much too young, he would report on his testosterone replacement therapy. He was pretty meticulous about his blood work leading up to the last couple of years of his life, because he actually had a health scare that made him, like, really dial things in. And unfortunately, the dialing things in was not enough to, you know, attenuate the risk of what he was doing. But he was pretty meticulous about getting his blood work done. He noticed some significant aberrations from different testosterone brands based on which compounding pharmacy he was using. he noticed a pretty significant change in his total T levels just by switching brands. So again, even if, like, just to be even proactive, personally, I would be getting blood work regularly anytime you switch medications if it's something that literally dictates your entire livelihood, your quality of life, your muscle building potential, etc. Get a new testosterone reading. See where you're at. You know, if you are switching a compounding pharmacy entirely, if you're like unaware if it's a reputable one or something like that, or you're not sure if the clinic you're working through is an ethical one and has the highest quality control in place, get your bloods done again. See what the fuck's going on. Because just because something comes from a compounding pharmacy doesn't actually, unfortunately, mean that it's going to be super on point and completely in line with what you were using previously. So if you're on 120 milligrams a week and you switch to a new brand and it's a totally different compounding pharmacy, like, it's entirely possible it could be underdosed. It's entirely possible you could end up fucking yourself up like Furious Pete did. Now, with him, was it a matter of the new brand was dosed like underdosed and it was like a poor quality pharmaceutical product? And when I say pharmaceutical, like, I mean, like, the compounding pharmacy producing it. Like, ultimately, some of these compounding pharmacies, like, I don't even know how they would get, you know, defined as pharmaceutical quality when some of them are so aberrant with what they should be doing. But ultimately, is that what happened with him? He switched to like one of these unethical, like, shady fucking pharmacies and ended up with like a UGL product, essentially? Or is it that he just didn't read the label properly? I'm not really sure. But ultimately, what it boils down to at the end of the day is, if he got blood work done, regardless if his test is like what the issue was, he would have seen it reflected in his blood work. He would have been able to decipher, based on his longitudinal data of his biomarkers, what the fuck? Usually I'm at like 700, 900, 750, 1000. And now all of a sudden I'm at 350. What is going on? If you had been checking your blood work properly in a long-term basis and created a longitudinal biological passport for yourself, you would essentially be able to identify very, very easily where the aberration was that is significantly hindering your quality of life and your health. So for him, like he mentioned, he's kind of blaming it on himself. And like, ultimately, it's unfortunate because when you're like low T as fuck, you might not even have like the ability, the problem solving capacity to even like think of something like that. Like, I know some individuals who are so like discombobulated when they're super low T that they don't even make logical, rational decisions. So it's unfortunate that he was put in this position. He just realized it a year and a half later that he's just been fucking his life up without getting a simple blood test done and seeing what's going on under the hood. So one thing I would say is, be proactive about this stuff and be regular about checking your blood work. If you're on TRT, if you're a bodybuilder blasting shit, even if you're natural, frankly, having a longitudinal profile of your biomarkers is going to allow you to have a more diversified portfolio, essentially representative of your health over time. So once you do encounter some sort of issue, you have this banked up data that you can then reference to see what went wrong and why. So I would highly recommend blood work for anybody, regardless if you're natural or not, but especially if you're on TRT or an enhanced individual, it is paramount that you prioritize it and you're proactive about getting it on a regular basis. So again, highly recommend you work with a highly qualified clinic with vetted doctors who represent the quality of information that is seen as high in the industry, that is reflective of the most cutting edge information and literature being presented on endocrinology, biology, hormone optimization, etc., as well as has the availability to get blood panels done on a regular basis and has self-service labs to do this yourself. If you don't want to go through a doctor every single time, just getting a basic, you know, follow-up of your hematology, metabolic parameters, thyroid levels, testosterone, estradiol, shit like that might be useful to do on a regular basis. And you don't necessarily need to get permission from a fucking doctor every time to do it and get charged for the consultation fee. You could get self-service labs, get a pre-designed panel, and or choose your own specific biomarkers that you need just to stay on top of what's under the hood. And then if you need to talk to a doctor because something is going wrong or something is off from the plan that was designed initially, you know, make a follow-up appointment. So anyways, that service I am more than very prideful to bring to the public, because this is something that I wish I had available when I was younger. You know, I used to go to the doctor and fucking beg for a lipid panel, just trying to be proactive about staying on top of my health. Instead of building up fucking plaque, I wanted to get in front of it. I wanted to see what the fuck is going on under the hood and make sure I could change my diet and or lifestyle accordingly in order to avoid that kind of an outcome. Because again, the way a lot of these kind of medical industry works, unfortunately, right now is wait until you get fucked up and then treat rather than preventative medicine and actually proactively assessing what's going on and allowing you to make minute small changes that can eventually cumulatively lead to a complete avoidance of some outcome that you may have been on a red line towards. So definitely check out my clinic in the video description if you want to get access to the highest quality medical oversight in this industry, as well as a very, very customizable self-service labs interface that you can otherwise stay on top of this kind of shit on your own time. If you don't want to work with a doctor, I would still recommend getting blood work, to be honest. So check it out, as well as anything else I'm associated with. Glad to hear that Furious Pete is on the mend and he figured out what's going on. But it's shitty that it was such like a basic thing that could have been figured out so easily had he just got an extra blood test done or whatever, followed the instructions correctly, like whatever it was. Better late than never, but just shitty to hear. It's unfortunate because I'm sure there are other individuals that may be able to, that probably fell into the same camp and had this kind of a thing happen or are currently enduring it right now. It's quite unfortunate. So anyways, glad to see he is back and hopefully healthy. So anyways, looking forward to seeing what he does in the future because he was always a bright spirit on the platform. The guy was very uplifting, very entertaining, and had a unique hybrid between fitness content and just like, you know, very, very mainstream appealing, entertaining stuff. So anyways, glad to see him back. Let me know what you guys think in the comments down below. All the comments help the algorithm. They're much appreciated. Like, subscribe, check out my blog, moreplatesmoredates.com. Follow me on Instagram, @moreplatesmoredates, Facebook, Snapchat, Twitter, TikTok, Apple Podcasts. If you want to support the channel, check out anything I'm associated with in the video description below. Merrick Health, like I mentioned, as far as the medical oversight, as well as my recommended labs and diagnostics. My recommended diet model for gaining muscle and sports performance whilst being mindful of micronutrient intake to stay as healthy as possible and improve your vitality whilst concurrently hitting your macros for muscle building and recovery. Gorilla Mind, nootropic formulas, Gorilla Mode pre-workout formulas, and Design Myself from Scratch, the clothing company that sponsors me. I'm literally wearing their shirt right now. And anything else I'm associated with, it's all in the video description below. Thank you guys for watching. Talk to you soon.